Hello everybody out there, welcome back to the channel. It's so great to see you again. And as Disney has dropped a new trailer, that means we are going to come and react to it, even though I'm not super thrilled to do it. Lately, every time I watch any trailer from Disney, I feel like I start trying to hype myself up, only to be disappointed every time the movie comes out. And I'm tired of doing that, because I don't think there's been a Disney film specifically that's come out that I've actually been excited for, like, since Encanto. Which, granted, wasn't that long ago, but there was a wide stretch before it. So that was worse than I thought it was. Encanto was good. That was worse than I thought it was. Now, granted, Disney says they have a lot riding on this. I was there when they talked about it at D23, and they said it's going to take a different visual style. They said it's going to really be a big film because it's going to be kind of a celebration of everything Disney feature animation, since it's the 100-year anniversary, and it's all about the Wishing Star. That's a really cool idea, but right now I'm sitting there going, well, with Disney's recent track record, I don't know if I trust them with this idea. But then, excuse me, emails, I'm trying to do a thing. Excuse my loud computer. So I'm going into this trailer, not ready to get my hopes up. And we'll see what happens. Maybe it'll surprise me. All right, let's do this.
Imagine a place.
Oh, there's Chris Pine.
Wishes.
Oh, it looks very watercolor and like it looks like a storybook a little bit.
A reality.
It's okay.
What if I told you that place.
Okay.
In reach. All you have to do is give your wish to me.
Oh, okay. Chris Pine is not happy. Okay. Oh, we've seen a lot of that concept art. Oh, here comes the Wishing Star.
Whoa.
Oh!
What was that?
Oh, it's kind of cute. Look at the little guy.
Whoa, what are you doing? Valentino's doing that?
It didn't work. When does the magic happen, huh?
Oh, the Ellen Tunic!
I am talking. Ha! Who knew my voice would be this low?
Okay, that was nice for Ellen Tunic. I like that. Okay, I'm digging the music. Okay, it comes out in November. Okay, we'll know for sure then what's going on. I kind of don't know how to feel. There are some things that give me hope. Like, I like the fact that they seem to be experimenting with the art style a little bit. Not as much as I would like. I personally would like to see Disney push it even further. Not just because I'm sitting here going, I want Spider-Verse or I want Puss in Boots too. No, it really comes to the fact that Disney poured a lot of time and a lot of money into experimenting with what visual things they can do with the art of animation. And they did some fantastic visual crazy stuff with this. But it's like they pushed so hard for all this. I was hoping for sure that was really going to play a big part into the films eventually. And I don't really see... I see bits of it here. It feels more like you put Frozen or Tangled or Moana and just put a filter over it. Which I know isn't what they did, but that's kind of the vibe that I get. The music sounds really cool. Obviously, I can't tell a lot from the story what's going to happen. What the main premise is. On paper, this seems like a good direction to go. It still feels very safe, but it at least seems like it's trying to move in another direction, even though part of me is like, you should do more faster, because that's what these other studios are doing. And honestly, it's getting everyone actually excited, and we want to go see it all more. Like, the main characters look great. I really am intrigued by whatever this king is doing. I don't know if he's a bad guy from the beginning and he's just a purely bad guy. I don't know if he's got like some crazy backstory.
I don't know who this girl is, who's the main wish girl. I really like her design. I think she looks really cool. Although, the design is a little bare basics to Tangled and Frozen, like I was talking about a second ago. But, that's also Disney. They kind of have a visual style. But, you know, you can branch off. You can branch off. It's not the end of the world if you branch off a little bit, but maybe they won't do that. I think them using Alan Tudyk as the voice of the goat was really good. But yeah, I want to get excited, but I partially can't be because I see so much that reminds me of what I'm kind of frustrated and tired of from Disney. But yet you're showing me elements that are showing me that you're trying to grow and you're trying to change. So I don't really know how I feel, but basically I'm ready to give this film a chance. But at the same time, I'm not ready to let myself get hyped up. I can't believe we're at a time where I'm saying this. I got hyped for an Illumination film, which I've never done, and I wasn't disappointed. I got hyped for a sequel to Puss in Boots, where I thought the first movie was eh, and I was like, I'm so done with the Shrek franchise, we don't need more. And yet, that movie won me over. I want to be that excited for Disney, and I don't think I can be. But at the same time, seeing the future of Disney kind of has me shaking my head, also just going like, okay, so Frozen 3, Zootopia 2... Actually, Zootopia 2 actually sounds cool. I'm actually not mad about that one. But Toy Story 5... Oh gosh, Toy Story 5. That stuff shouldn't be coming. What, we have 8 new live-action remakes that are coming, one of them being Moana. I want to be excited, but so much around the Disney company right now is showing me don't be excited because it's just going to be the same rehashed stuff you're tired of. But there's enough promise to show me that at least maybe they recognize and they're trying. So thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And let me know in the comments, what do you guys think about this? Do you think I'm being too hard on it? What do you guys think? Curious to hear your thoughts below. All right, I'll see you guys later. Bye!